Good morning. While dealing with civil law, one must clearly understand the Contract Act. Contract Act is main source of law. Though there are many sources of law, but even for other sources, there must be a contract, whether written or implied. Sovereignty is a source of law, but unless and until you accepted the sovereignty, then only even that law is applicable to you. Like Constitution, if unless you are a citizen, if there is an implied contract, then only that source of law applicable. So, to understand Contract Act, basic things has to be understood. What is that? Section 2 should be read carefully, once, twice, thrice. It says that if any person signifies his willingness to do or abstain from some doing, is called proposal. You have to signify that I am ready to do this. I am ready to not to do this. That is called proposal. Then, if that significance is accepted by the other side, that is called accepted, becomes promise. That is acceptance, that is promise. Then, the person who is signifies his proposal is called promisor, and who accept that is called promisee. Then you have to see that if you signifies your proposal to do or not to do with some offer, that offer may also be for to do or not to do. That is called consideration. Practically speaking, consideration is money. But under Indian Contract Act, the consideration may be money or doing some act or even bottom system, any property. That is called consideration. Then, if your promise is accepted by each other, that is called agreement. If you promise something, the other side demands some more things, and you accept that and he accepts that, that agreement is called reciprocal promises agreement. Then, all agreements are not contract, but contract is an agreement, that is valid agreement. Which agreement is not enforceable under law is void agreement. If the agreement is enforceable under law, it's called contract. Then what is voidable? Void means both parties could not execute the contract. Voidable contract means one party can enforce that contract, but the other party cannot. That is called a voidable contract. Like a minor, the other person who was insane but subsequently became sane, he can revoke the contract on attaining sanity. That is called a voidable contract. Then certain contracts becomes void because of enforceable law. Question then arises, how the acceptance has to be decided, judged? That is called communication. Communication means, if you send that communication, your part is over. If it is received by them, his part is over. That is very simple. For suppose a person send a letter to sell his house to X, if he sends that letter, his proposal is over. If he accept that letter, his acceptance is over. it is subject to revocation subsequently. So this is most important. Then one things are that all agreements are contract. That is section 10. But that section 10 says if it is compulsorily registrable, stamped according to prescribed law, this agreement may not be a contract if there is any lack of statutory compilation. Then the question of competence to contract. You must thoroughly go through the section 11, what is competent to contract, because Contract Act is very old act. This competent to contract is being appropriated, incorporated in several acts. So you being a law student, or if you are writing judgment examination, you can use this section 11 wherever the other this competent to contract has been described in so many acts, so many Society Registration Act, Companies Act, so Partnership Act, all these things are, this word is being appropriated there. So for competent to contract, basic requirement is that he should be major on his subject means, if he is in India, the majority age is completion of 18. If suppose in some other country where only 16 years was there, on completion of 16 years, he be a major, then that subject law is applicable. So major. Then he should be sound mind. He should not be unsound mind. That means he is suffering from insanity. Then the question arises that he is not disqualified by any other statutory person. Insolvent, convict persons are not competent to contract, subject to other provisions. So these three major things has to be understood. Then major part of Contract Act is that pre-consent. If you are giving consent, that is acceptance, or if you are making proposal, that acceptance should be free, with free consent. For free consent, there are certain prohibition. Number one, coercion, then undue influence, fraud, misrepresentation, mistake. Therefore, if you have to go through the contract completely, Contract Act is limited to this up to section 14. Thereafter, some definitions are there, elaborately you have to understand. We will go through that and independently by citing judgment. So for Contract Act is concerned, this is my deliberation to understand the Contract Act. Best wishes.